Sometimes Milo can be a hard-working little tank engine, but he can be a cheeky one too. He once woke Bella from her nap by whistling rudely at her. Leaving Bella very cross. One day, Milo was dozing off in his shed. He was very tired. He was just going to sleep when the tweenie controller arrived.
Milo, I need you to pick up some passengers from the big station.
Yes, sir, yawned Milo, and he puffed away. He grumbled into the station where Fizz was waiting. Be careful not to bump the coaches, said Fizz. They don't like being bumped. I know that, said Milo, and he fussed away. But Milo didn't realize that he left the brake coach behind. Milo fussed along the countryside. Up ahead, he saw Jake in his way. Hurry up, called Milo. Jake was very cross, so he did not move. So Milo waited until he got to the next station. Milo got very impatient. Hurry up, the lot of you, he called to them. The passengers were very cross. Next, Milo came to Sid's tunnel. Sid was very surprised that Milo did not have a brake coach. Where's your brake coach, he cried, but Milo fussed away. The coach's chance had come. Horror, horror, they cried, and banging their buffers, they pushed Milo down the hill. Yelled the coaches. I've got to stop, roared Milo. And without a brake coach, Milo couldn't stop. Disaster lay ahead. Poor Milo hung dangerously over the edge. He was relieved to have stopped. Then, the tweenie controller arrived on board Doodles. He was very cross.
You should have waited. And now you have caused confusion and delay. You left the brake coach, whistled at Jake, and bumped your coaches. You should learn to change your attitude.
Sorry, sir, said Milo, and he let off a sad we should steam. Isles took Milo's coaches and Bella took Milo to the works to have his trunk repaired. Milo felt very ashamed of himself. Night, he apologized to Bella. I'm sorry I was cheeky, said Milo. That's all right, said Bella. I'm in disgrace.